You're listening to The Alex Jones Show. Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Coming up, the feds raid the NFL. Why do I think they're doing that? Obama says that open borders strains the country, hurts blue-collar Americans, hurts the welfare system. That's all coming up as he prepares to become a true dictator with all these executive orders. But I want to take a lot of your phone calls in this hour ahead of investigative journalist John Rappaport joining us. Dan, Kevin, Mike, Dion, Brad, we're going to all of you. And again, when you hear somebody hang up, that's your cue to call in. I'm taking a lot of calls. Dan in Ohio, you're on the air.
Hello, Alex Jones. This is Bible Dan with the Bible in his hand.
All right.
I got two talking points here. One is the border. Well, the Lord is going to make sure he's the only one we can count on to keep those borders closed. We cannot count on man. Man will not save us, only Yeshua. My second talking point is you got a problem with Revelations. It says Revelations 3:10. It says, I will keep you from the hour of the trial that dwells on those on the earth. Okay? Not the believers. And then you got 1 Timothy 4:16. It says, for the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, with the sound of the trumpet of God, and...
Are you saying that you believe in a pre-tribulation rapture?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, listen, I got to jump because I said, you know, we're getting into like 20 topics I threw out, and I guarantee I don't think one of these callers will be on one of those topics. And that's fine. That's the weird thing we do on the show. Sometimes it's great, sometimes it's not. I'm not mad at you, but I'm not having a theological debate right now. It says the beast will wage war on the saints and overcome them. How'd that happen when they're all teleported out of here? What happened to Jesus? What happened to his disciples? Did they get raptured? What happened to Christians in Nazi Germany or in the Soviet Union? God helps those that helps themselves. You take action, then God gives you providence. George Washington didn't just sit there and pray that God would come destroy the Redcoats. He prayed that God would guide his hand defeating them. Trust in God, but tie up your camel, is the old Bedouin saying, and I agree with it. Hunter S. Thompson said, trust in God, but row away from the rocks. And we could control our border. We could prosecute people that hire illegals. We could not give them all free welfare, and they wouldn't be here. They incentivize it, and that's what goes on in these big mega churches. That's all that goes on. Is a lay down, don't get involved, do what you're told. It's a government doctrine of failure. And I'm not mad at you, sir, and I understand we should trust in God. I do trust in God. That's why I'm not in fear. But I'm just always hearing from so-called Christians, hey, Yahweh's going to take care of it. But I still got to put my shoes on in the morning. I still got to take care of my kids. I got to tell my kids don't run out in the street when they were little. No, I'm not going to tell them to do that. I'm just going to, or if somebody speeds down my street, I'm not going to say something to them because God will handle it. No, I'm going to say something to them. If I'm at the gas station 20 minutes later and see the guy that went 80 miles an hour down my street, I'm going to say, listen, I'm not looking for trouble, buddy, but you're going to run over somebody's kid going down the street like that. And if they bow up and want to physically attack me, I'm going to beat that. I'm going to defeat them because they're going to kill somebody. I'm not looking for trouble. But, you know, you see somebody driving 80 miles an hour down the street, you got to go tell them, don't do it. Remember, I used to drive down the street maybe 35, 40 miles an hour. And I see neighbors getting mad and stuff and, you know, see them say, hey, slow down. And I kind of would slow down going, oh, I guess they're right, but still wasn't being reckless. But, man, now I see people going down residential areas like 80 miles an hour. I want to, you know, I get really angry. That's dangerous, folks. You're going to kill somebody. What am I going to do, just pray to God? Yeah, I pray to God my kids are safe every day when they drive, when people drive them around. Number one cause of death for kids is automobile accidents. But at the same time, I tell the nanny or whatever, I want you to drive extra safe. You know, the person I hire to be a nanny has got to have a perfect driving record. You understand that?
After consulting top doctors, nutritionists, pharmacists, and others, we have developed what I believe is the ultimate non-GMO organic Super Male Vitality formula. Super Male Vitality by InfoWars Life is so powerful that I only take half the recommended dose.
I jump out of bed ready to fight these criminals every day. I look forward to waking up and taking my Super Male Vitality.
Visit InfoWarsLife.com today to secure your Super Male Vitality and other powerful products from InfoWars Life.
The government's Department of Homeland Security is buying up loads of ammo. At the same time, they're restricting civilians' rights to own and purchase firearms. Can you put two and two together? Infidel Body Armor can stop every round, including hollow points and 308 sniper rounds, is reasonably priced and fully legal. But for how long? Go to InfidelBodyArmor.com, spelled I-N-F-I-D-E-L, BodyArmor.com. Infidel Body Armor just won't quit.
In the near future.
When you realize how fake it all is, the football, the basketball.
Alert. Security alert. This is Homeland Security. Analysis. InfoWars building independent media operations.
We let the worst people get controlled and tell us that we are the ones responsible.
Prime Directive. Discredit Alex Jones.
Jones is the wildly popular conspiracy theorist.
It's a popular conspiracy theory talk show called InfoWars.
Alex Jones is now in an Austin jail.
These people are assaulting us.
Targeting of patriots engaged.
They are never going to stop. They're never going to deviate from their program until we stop them.
Block free iPhone app at InfoWars.com. Block free podcast and video feed. Imperative. Destroy Prison Planet TV.
You gotta set your eye on the enemy, not worry about what propaganda they put out. Intellectually, it's begun. You can feel it.
When I first got online and I seen the price of the X2 and the DNA Force, I was a little hesitant, but I pulled the trigger on it. It has changed my life. I've been taking it for about 24 days now, pounding the weight, staying in shape.
InfoWarsLife.com. You've heard the callers of the show.
Several months back, I started taking your Nason Iodine and your Super Meal. Prior to this, I was barely walking. Now I'm able to function as a human again.
Whether it's Survival Shield, Nason Iodine, or DNA Force, Super Male Vitality, Super Female Vitality, Lung Cleanse, Fluoride Shield, Oxy Powder. I believe that all of these products will blow you away like they've done the thousands of other customers that have visited InfoWarsLife.com.
That's true. Just amazing what it's able to do to actually detox in the body. It's great stuff.
If I'm going to promote something, it's got to be something I personally use and that I believe in. Check out InfoWarsLife.com today and the entire line of groundbreaking, cutting-edge, hardcore products.
He's the T-Rex of political talk. Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network.
Examples out today of celebrities doing something good with their power. Neil Young has come out and said that because Starbucks has joined a lawsuit against the state of Vermont and their new law saying that GMO products have to be labeled, well, you know how much sugar's in them, you know how much fat's in them. Of course you should know if a genetically modified organism is in there, like BT corn that kills the honeybees that come in contact with it. It's designed to kill bugs so that the crops don't get eaten, but it also hurts you. He says, I used to line up and get my latte every day, but yesterday was my last one, the rocker announced. And then separately, that story's up on InfoWars.com via Rolling Stone. We now have Pat Sajak coming out saying that Gruber comments about how Americans are dumb and how they deceived them illustrates the elitism of the left, and said that's what the politicians really think of the American people in a tweet. Good job, Pat Sajak. And of course, look for Neil Young to get harassed now. Look for Pat Sajak to get harassed, just like Bill Cosby. Now, did Bill Cosby in his long career as a superstar ever force himself on a woman? Maybe. But he doesn't fit that M.O. But a woman 30 years ago, and then after that, other women claim 30 years later that he raped them. And you'd think it was the end of the world right now for the former Jell-O sponsor. I know this. This is politically motivated, clearly, to punish him for criticizing Obamacare and Obama. In the last few years, I've said, look out, Bill Cosby, because I've seen this over and over again. They come after you. They fire you. They restrict you. Just like the comedian a month ago who criticized vaccines and autism, they dropped him from his insurance sponsoring. State Farm, Rob Schneider. So that's what I think is going on here. And we have to learn to support people who get targeted. I'm going to your calls, but I want to tie it into this. We're going to talk to our reporters on the ground coming up. Navy vet labeled a terrorist for posting images of DHS vehicles in Missouri. Hotel staffer asked if vehicles were linked to impending Ferguson arrest. And so DHS went and got him fired from his job. Well, somebody needs to contact them and get him rehired or said hire this Navy vet who's now been fired for simply being a citizen asking questions and putting it out on their Facebook. See, our reporters get targeted. So does Vice of HBO. So does Al Jazeera by the police. You'll see the commanders, you know, basically ordering the troops, as they call them, the militarized police, to shoot us with rubber bullets when we are there 200 yards away covering it. They won't go after looters. They won't go after folks with Molotov cocktails. They go after the press because they're being trained because the government wants information dominance. Well, that's not what you do in a free society. That's why Obama has persecuted the press like no one else in history. Even the left admits nobody's gone after the press and indicted and arrested people for reporting on corruption like Barack Hussein Obama. Also coming up, school teaches kids that the government gives us our rights. That's a Paul Joseph Watson article on Infowars.com. And study links depression, anxiety, and lethargy to vitamin B12 deficiency. That report's up on Infowars.com. I covered that last hour. Important information. Meanwhile, Chicago schools teaching safe anal sex to fifth graders. Presentation includes instructions on applying condoms prior to anal sex. Maybe they'll teach him about sex with someone's ear. I mean, you know, why not? Same-sex marriage? Well, how about... all right, I'm just going to leave it right there. That's not what school's about, ladies and gentlemen. That shouldn't be going on with seniors, much less with fifth graders. Outrageous. Kevin, Luke, Dion, Brad, Rhonda, I'm going to your calls, bang, bang, bang. Kevin, you're on the air. You want to talk about Gruber. Go ahead.
I was wondering how Gruber sleeps at night and was wondering how we could get him indicted, not only him, but everyone that's involved with this fraud. I mean, I think it's a giant screw job, and he openly, you know, admits it. So I was wondering, how do we get them all indicted?
Well, I appreciate that question. It's an excellent question. I'll put you on hold while I answer it and then go back to you, Kevin. The way this should work is they call Gruber, they call Ezekiel Emanuel, they call all the people that shot their mouths off about how it's death panels, how it's meant to wreck health care, how it's a screw job, how it's meant to kill old people, how it's meant to bankrupt the country, how they lied about what it cost, how they lied about the tax, and you grill them so that it becomes a media spectacle and you get their crimes out in the open. Then you indict Obama in the House of Representatives. You indict him. And then you have the trial in the Senate. And the thought is, well, that makes him a victim and might boost his poll numbers. No, not when it's this egregious. Not when everybody's being hit with the premium increases in Obamacare. The Democrats are screaming for vengeance. And then you impeach Obama. There'll be a landslide. Boehner will be removed from the House as the Speaker, the leader of the Senate will be removed, not from office, but will be removed from leadership. In that landslide, it'll give cover to all those politically that are being blackmailed or attacked. We could rout the entire group. Then you've got to put heat on the next power group, not to be bought off of the same interest, letting them know they'll be politically destroyed.